Hi, I'm Scott.
And I'm Oscar, and this is the Queen. And together we are the Ginfluencers UK.
And the Queen. The gin we're trying today is Keepr's Platinum Jubilee Windsor Great Park Honey Infused London Dry Gin.
Big label, big label.
That's a lot going on.
To celebrate the Queen's 70th year reign, they have made a limited edition run of 840 bottles to mark the same number of months the Queen has reigned.
Keepr's use their signature London Dry Gin and infuse it with 100% pure honey from beehives from where? From Windsor Great Park.
Oh, there you go. Stroke of luck.
Yep, the botanicals include juniper berries, coriander, angelica seeds, orris root, cinnamon, cardamom, angelica root, licorice root, lemon peel, and some bitter orange. So that's the standard one. Then obviously they put in the honey from Windsor Great Park.
There you go. That's how you do it.
Your Majesty's bees.
It comes in a 70 centilitre bottle, which is a lovely purpley colour, with an ABV of 42% for £38. Not bad. Today we will be making a gin and tonic using premium tonic water and garnishing with some orange peel and fresh ginger.
As always, we'll be trying it neat first. So let's get to it.
There you go. Oh, this is a lovely coloured bottle. And look, it's all bobbly like a beehive.
Oh yeah,
as in bee
the honeycomb. Yeah, as in the honeycomb. Yeah. Yeah. Well, I did say beehive rather than apiary because Oscar would be like, oh, "There's no apes in it." or you say, "Stop monkeying around."
Hurry up and open the bottle.
All right, you chimpanzee.
Now let me see how big this label is.
Well, it's not. Yeah, there's a lot written
on
it.
You made it seem like a lot bigger.
I mean, there's a lot of wording on there.
And just remember, save the bees.
And the Queen.
And also, they give 10% to support the British Bee Conservation.
There you go.
There you go, you can't go wrong with that.
Can't go wrong with that.
Sorry, yeah. Mom.
Ma'am. God save the Queen and God save the bees. There you go. Cheers.
Oh, yeah, ginny gin. Oh, it's very sweet, which takes away from the alcohol completely.
Yeah.
It's very sweet.
I think the difference with this one being it isn't kind of themed in any other way. Ooh. All they've done is, this is a take on their regular one. So their regular one, they have a London Dry that is sweetened with honey. And this is what they've done, but it's with, it's with honey from Windsor Park. But that's the connection. That's the connection to Her Royal Highness. And the Jubilee is the fact is where the honey comes from. So this is actually kind of their kind of regular gin anyway. So it's not going to taste anything like the ones we've had before.
And I think this is very sweet and very enjoyable.
It is very enjoyable. And it's a really lovely smell.
It is indeed. It is a lovely smell.
It's quite a piney smell.
It's very menthol. See, the menthol sort of got to me a moment ago because it is very... It's very there.
Take a few more sips though, because the honey is really mellowing it out. It's
good.
It's becoming a lot softer. Mm.
I think once you get to the taste, oh, there you go. Some flavors are coming through now. Once you get through the initial shock of the menthol hit, yeah. Which it definitely was. It was knocked me for six.
Really overly fresh, piney. Like, yeah. Once the softness comes in from the honey.
And now it's completely taken away from that. Mm. It's all gone now. And now I'm getting the sweetness of the honey. I'm getting some flavours coming through on that. Some really nice sort of sweet flavours there.
It's a little bit like a super juniper Old Tom. Because Old Tom's dialed back the juniper a bit and they're kind of very sweet. This has got the kind of sweetness in and those kind of like the lovely warm flavours. And sweet kind of sticky feel, but you're getting juniper from it.
Sorry, sorry, ma'am. I keep on doing
don't
that.
Don't touch Her Majesty. No.
Sorry.
Yeah. Off of his head. See?
Now that you've said that, yes, it is a more junipery type of, you could associate that with an Old Tom.
Yeah.
Yep, definitely.
And the smell's great. What do you think, ma'am?
Wonderful. Save the bees, save the geese.
Scotland again. No, I think she said, save the bees.
Let's try it with some tonic.
Let's try it with some tonic. Okay. Let's give it a try. Cheers.
Cheers, Scott.
We just gave our camera operative a rendition of Fleetwood Mac.
Oh yeah, that was indeed. Oh wow, okay. See, I think the ginger has really helped it.
See, it's not what we kind of thought of as a Jubilee gin, but it's just basically what they do anyway. It's what their signature gin is, their London Dry, that has honey in it. The difference is, the thing that makes it Jubilee is the introduction of honey from Great Windsor Park.
One of her gardens. A flat over in Windsor.
No, it's not. It's her house. It's Windsor Castle. So that's what makes it a Jubilee.
Okay, so it is basically their normal gin, but with different honey.
Yes.
Simple as that.
Simple as that.
And it's in a purple bottle.
Because that's the colours of the Jubilee.
It's quite nice. I'm definitely getting some juniper come through on that.
There's a lot of juniper.
And I'm getting sweetness of the honey. But they're the two sort of flavours I'm getting. That's pretty much it. The sweetness from the honey, which is giving it a taste, and the juniper of the juniper.
I don't think it's bad gin at all.
No.
I do think, though, that we're so used to, in this kind of Jubilee head that we've had on lately, we've been kind of focused on
strawberries and berries,
and everything seemed to be garnished with a strawberry and had those kind of berry flavors.
So they've done a slightly different take. They've kept the same sort of flavor.
Yeah.
They've just used an element of
Her Royal Highness.
Her Royal Highnessness.
Yeah.
I can see why they've done that, because there is a connection there. It'd be tenuous if they said, oh, we use different honey, it's got nothing to do with her. But it has got a connection to her. So well done. Well done to that. And also they're saving the bees. Which is very good.
And no doubt if there were, when His Royal Highness Prince Charles becomes king, they'll probably use bees from Highgrove.
Highgrove.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If they let him. I'm sure they will. Yeah.
Well, you never know.
Yeah, if he likes them.
This is interesting, because I think you're right. We were so focused on all these Jubilee gins that have come out of very, very different flavours, very different tastes.
Yeah.
Whereas this one is a...
It's a gin.
It's a very strong taste. It's a very strong gin. And it's actually, it's effectively one of their base sort of gins.
But it's actually a gin, that's it. So it's not base, it's actually a gin, rather than a gin, that they've changed slightly and stuff. If you can hear lots of noise, I'm really sorry. The cat has figured out how to work this dog's toy that we've got. There's a puzzle, and he's really clever. So I've hidden treats in there for the dog, and the cat's actually figured it out, and he actually knows how to work a dog puzzle. He's a really clever cat.
That's really annoying.
It's really annoying.
Okay,
anyway, let's give it a score.
Yeah, let's score this.
There you go.
He must have smashed that puzzle by now.
He's actually so bright. He's such a clever cat.
Let me just try again, just to make sure I'm right.
It's a shame we don't give halves.
No, we're staying away from halves because we confuse everyone with the extra 11.
Right, go.
Go for it.
Yeah.
Okay. Yep.
See, I was going to go kind of 8.5 if we had halves, if you allowed me to
We're
go
not
for
doing
a half.
Halves. We're not. It's getting too confusing.
Yeah, it's a really good gin. Mm. I really, really like it.
It's got the sharpness.
Yeah. But it's a gin. So it is a take on the kind of the Jubilee thing, because of the Jubilee honey.
I think it's very good, actually, that they've gone down that route. So it's got a real connection to
Her Royal Highness.
Her Majesty.
Yeah, Her Majesty.
Her Majesty. Mm. I'm not going to do that because I've got a bad back.
You will bow in front of
If I was getting an OBE,
queen.
Trust me, I would, but I'm not at the moment, so let's not. Damehood.
There's nothing like a dame.
it's very interesting. I like the fact that they're giving money to the bees.
Yeah.
Because the bees are incredibly important. We love bees. We're looking at buying a what was it called?
An apiary.
An apiary, a hatchery, a chicken pen. I don't know what it's called.
We're thinking of one of them because I do love honey. And we've really enjoyed doing these Jubilee videos, haven't we?
Yeah, we have. Yeah, we have indeed.
This is the last one in it. Ooh. And, you know, we have a big queen. And we have a little queen.
So this is the first video she's been in, and that probably cost about 400 quid. I have no idea how much that cost.
No.
So it's been in one video for about two and a half seconds.
She came free with that one.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh my, what is the point of...
So anyway.
Anywho, right. So I hope you all have a great Jubilee.
Yeah, I hope you...
Or you've already had it.
Or you've already had it. Depends when this video goes out.
Yeah, we're undecided at the moment, actually.
But God save the queen.
Indeed. God save you.
Cheers.
See you in this next video, and click and like and subscribe.
Cheers.
Cheers. Bye-bye.
God save the Queen.